Hello everyone, my name is Sachin Bhandari and you're watching my YouTube channel Eccentric Sachin. In this video, I am going to talk to you about a story and also an interesting storyteller. This was back in October of 2020. Those nights, I found myself in the hill town of Chamba in Himachal Pradesh. My in-laws had spent most of their time in Bombay and Delhi, but decided to move to their, you know, city of their roots after their retirement. Then one day we got a call saying that both of them had been admitted to the hospital because of COVID, of course. We had to rush, my wife and I, we had to rush from Bombay to Chamba. It's a flight to Delhi, from Delhi to another flight to Pathankot, and from Pathankot it's a back-breaking ride to the hill town of Chamba. When we got there, we realized that there was so much work to do in terms of, you know, running to and fro from the hospital, making sure that everything was all right. And the fact that my wife or I, neither of us had ever lived in Chamba, just made things a tad more difficult. In those days, to find some solace, I picked up a book called Aimless in Banaras. And in this video, I want to talk to you about the book, but more importantly, about the writer of that book and other books that he has written. And what happened eventually in Chamba is something that I'll let you know towards the end of the video. So stay with me. I was talking to you about this author called Bishwanath Ghosh. He's the one who wrote the book Aimless in Banaras. After I finished reading that book, I was happy to know that Mr. Ghosh had written 4 other books. Though his work is not something that I found very impressive with the first book that I read, I still decided to go ahead and read a couple of his other books. The one that I picked after that was called Gazing at Neighbors. Now, Gazing at Neighbors is a very interesting travelogue. Bishwanath Ghosh travels to cities and towns which are close to the border of either Pakistan or Bangladesh. In this book, he actually goes to places which are associated with the origin of Sikhism. He also visits something called a chit in West Bengal. These are, you know, enclaves of Bangladesh within India, and similar kind of enclaves of India exist within Bangladesh. And, you know, I think some time ago these enclaves were swapped and people from these enclaves were sort of given citizenship of the respective country, or at least they were allowed to choose whichever country they wanted to go to. So these kind of stories form a part of Gazing at Neighbors. It's a fascinating journey which showcases so many interesting things about the border of our fantastic country. That was the first book. The book that I read after that was called Chai Chai. If you are like me, you will sort of directly associate it with railway stations, and you wouldn't be wrong. This book is about, you know, those lesser known railway junctions across India, places like Mughalsarai, Itarsi, Jhansi in the north, or places like Arakkonam, Guntakal, Shoranur in the south. Bishwanath Ghosh actually travels to these small, I mean, not small stations, big stations in small cities, and tries to find out the story of these cities. So he goes out into the city to find a place to stay, and that itself becomes a story. And while the book is fairly straightforward and may not be his finest work because it was his first book, it does have its moments, and it delivers a straightforward book with some memorable, you know, times. But the most important thing about the book is to get a glimpse of towns or cities which you otherwise may never visit or otherwise may not even care reading about. And that, I think, is sort of the masterstroke of this particular book. After Chai Chai, I actually took a break. I wasn't really reading Bishwanath Ghosh's books because we moved from Bombay to Mysuru in December of 2020. When I was here in Mysore, I started longing to read a travelogue on this city. When I looked for travelogues on this city, I really couldn't find anything. And so I said, let's read a travelogue on some other South Indian city. And that's when I came across this book called Tamarind City. Tamarind City is a book on Chennai written by Bishwanath Ghosh. Now, interestingly, Bishwanath Ghosh lived in this city, or at least lived at the time he wrote the book, for almost a decade. So in a way, it was his tribute to the city of his residence. If the first two books were interesting, this one was really fabulous. And I think my respect for him as a writer really grew with this particular book. because there were so many interesting stories about Chennai which I would have not found out without Vishwanath Ghosh's writing. Sample this. We all think that the Brit Empire started in India in Calcutta, but that's not true. At least Vishwanath Ghosh reveals that in the book. Fort St. George is the first fort that the Brits built, and that was in Chennai. Apart from that, the book also has, you know, like a funny take or an interesting take on the rivalry between the Iyers and the Iyengars. It also has a very fascinating family story of a Tamil superstar of yore. His name is Jemini Ganesan. I would definitely suggest that you pick up the book if you are interested in Chennai. After Tamarind City, the last book, I mean, it's a book that I'm still reading, I'm on the last chapter. It's called Longing and Belonging, An Outsider at Home in Kolkata. I hope I got that right. Now, most of us would believe that Vishwanath Ghosh, writer, he's a journalist, he probably comes from Calcutta, but that's not the truth. He grew up in a city in Kanpur, and he knew Kolkata only from a distance through his relatives. But after his marriage, I mean, his wife comes from Kolkata, so over multiple visits, he wrote a book about Calcutta, which I can say is probably one of the better travel books that I have written. I hope to write travel books someday. So in this book, you get to read a lot about, you know, the interesting stories from Calcutta, about Mohan Bagan, about, K.C. Das, and the Bhadralok culture. You also get to read about different artists. All in all, it presents a really fascinating and myriad picture of Calcutta. And I would definitely suggest that all of you, whoever is interested in travel or in these cities, should read Vishwanath Ghosh's books. His stories are straightforward, you know, stories which hide in plain sight. His love for bringing out the colors and everyday of life of India is also pretty interesting. And you know, if you are somebody who loves traveling, then he actually also brings the little things of travel that, you know, most of us don't ever talk about finding a hotel room, about having a simple meal. All of these stories get narrated in his book, so I really like him and I'm looking forward to more of his books. Those were the four books, but the book that I started with in this video was called Aimless in Banaras. I didn't tell you anything about that, but let me tell you what Aimless in Banaras is all about, and more importantly, what was the story when I picked up the book and decided to read more of Vishwanath Ghosh's books. After a few days, when we reached Chamba, my mother-in-law battled COVID and she actually succumbed to the virus and she passed away. Understandably, this was a very difficult time for my wife, her brother, her father. We had rushed from Mumbai. My brother-in-law had rushed all the way from Canada. There wasn't enough time for any of us to process what was happening. Tempers were frayed. We were all stressed out. Of course, everybody in the family was heartbroken. I don't know if I managed or if I did a good job of helping the family. But I do know that if I did a good job, or if I have done a good job, the credit, or at least some of it, should go to the book Aimless in Banaras. Because in this book, Vishwanath Ghosh deals with similar questions. His mother had passed away before he started writing the book. If I'm not wrong, she was also cremated, or her funeral was conducted in Banaras, which is where most Hindus think is the best place for a person to start his final journey. And Vishwanath Ghosh also deals with similar questions that my wife and I were dealing with during that period, about the meaning of life and death and why do certain things happen. Despite the heaviness of the time that I was facing, the book felt like a responsible escape. After dealing with the entire day and the day-to-day challenges that we were facing as a couple and as a family, it was good to, you know, go to sleep with those 60 minutes that I used to spend with the book, because it used to give me solace, it used to give me peace, and it also used to give me answers to some of the questions that we were facing, and maybe that helped me that much more to deal with the situation at hand. So that's the interesting but not very happy story behind the book. And that's what great writers do. You know, they help us contextualize, they help us find answers, they help us seek solace, even if we don't realize that we are doing that at that point in time. And that's exactly what Aimless in Banaras did. So while Ghosh's work may not come across as the most outstanding, or it may not be part of avant-garde literature or, you know, terms like those, I think he's a fabulous writer who helps you get an escape, who helps you find some peace in this hustle and bustle of daily life, or, you know, the challenges that we face in our lives. So I would definitely recommend that you pick up his books. I've narrated, or I've spoken about all five of them. Please pick up whichever you find interesting and start your journey with Bishwanath Ghosh as soon as you can. That's it from me in this video. I'll see you in the next one pretty soon.